if you are in Manhattan and you haven't seen Uptown, have you really seen Manhattan?
No!
No! So this video is going to be about the fancier side of Manhattan. Uptown, Upper West Side, Upper East Side.
I'm digging through the glove box. I thought I had a map in here. The driver's door doesn't lock. I bought the car my junior year. There's candy in my backpack. And you can pick our soundtrack. We're heading for the East Coast tonight.
This video is going to be about how to reach Uptown, what all to do here, what all to eat. And also, stay tuned till the end because we're going to go to Central Park. And in Central Park are some amazing photo opportunities and photo spots. So you're going to see that as well. And he's our photographer for the day.
And
how are you feeling about it?
I'm feeling good. I'm totally prepared.
Yeah?
And also, we have a big day planned ahead for Shashi. We know all the... We have an itinerary which will take her through that. So we'll have some breakfast, then we'll enjoy Central Park, and then we'll end our day with some time on the Fifth Avenue. So it's gonna be a big day. So stay tuned.
How to reach Uptown? Okay, how do we reach Uptown? First place. Let's start
with
that.
Depends where you're coming from. We're coming from Hoboken, so we actually took a bus into Midtown and then we took the subway because we didn't want to walk a lot. We wanted to save our feet for the park.
But wherever you are, just use Google Maps. They're the best. Google.
City. The gist of it is that Uptown is connected by the subway. So you can very easily take the subway and reach Uptown. So we are at our first stop for today. It's a brunch place called Cafe Lau. Kafi fancy jagah hai. And this cafe is extremely pretty. And it's also been featured in movies like You've Got Mail. They don't take reservation here, so it's on first come first serve basis. So be ready to even wait a little bit in line before you get seated.
Thanks, this all looks very nice. Wow. Oh yeah, breakfast, lunch.
Hi, Sam.
Stroll the Midtown streets and tell me that you don't feel giddy. Lady Liberty ain't throwing us a wink or is she? Travel light and see the world right. You'll never know if you never go. So run away with me and say hello to New York.
In New York or anywhere in US, right? If you are going to a restaurant where you're sitting and having food, tipping is essential. And what's the normal percentage? Okay, 18% is considered good. So you start with it. You generally start with it.
Locals tip, they normally tip around 20% for the average service. The service is really bad, they tip 15%. But if you ask an Indian or someone, they'll normally tip between.
So, how much should
I tip? If you had a good time, be generous, tip 18-20%.
Remember to tip anywhere between 18-20% whenever you come out to eat. And there's no need to tip for takeaways, no need to tip. In supermarkets, it's not required, it's only in restaurants like this that you're being served. So after brunch, we are on the way to Central Park. And yes,
come on. The trivia I wanted to share with you, which I find very interesting, is that of course it's like a big park, but it's not the biggest park in New York.
It's not?
It's not. It's the biggest park.
In New York? Oh wow.
It's the fifth biggest. I don't know if it's the fifth biggest, but the biggest park in New York is actually in Bronx. So Central Park, contrary to popular imagination, is not the biggest, though it's huge.
But the most popular.
Of course it's the most popular. Yeah. It's the prettiest part.
So how many hours do we plan to spend? What's like a good length of time?
You can spend the whole day here, but I think today we'll spend like what, 3-4 hours?
Yeah, 3-4 hours.
Yeah. And we'll only cover a part of the park because in one day it's physically impossible to cover
everything.
The entire park.
So we are going to be there for 3 hours. So let's see what all we can do in those 3 hours. And one more great thing about Central Park is that it's free. you don't have to spend any money to enjoy Central Park. Very close to Central Park is the Museum of Natural History, which is what you see behind me. And if you're really into museums, you can come here. The entry fee is about $26. And if you're spending a day here, then this is one of the things that you can include in your itinerary for that day. Okay, so we have some trivia and and lesser known information about Central Park.
Yeah.
Let's go.
So, the fifth biggest park in New York, but the most visited. If you want to know the area, it's around 800 plus acres. And the it was completed in around 1880s something, 1870s.
Wow, that's old.
Yeah, it took some time to, because it's like huge.
Yeah.
It's 4 kilometers long, around 0.8 kilometers wide. So, it's huge, like it's around 10 kilometers in perimeter. So if you want to have a good run, you can just run around Central Park and you'll be done for the day.
It's a good running loop.
It's a good running loop, very beautiful. Okay. There's seven lakes, so
inside Central Park?
Inside Central Park. And they were created by damming or like controlling the flow of natural
water. Okay.
So if you want to have a picnic on a sunny day, just come here with a basket and a bottle of wine.
The number one thing to do in Central Park is to take a stroll. Just take a stroll without any agenda. And I think the best time to come is either after brunch or after lunch, which you can choose to do in a place nearby. And come here and just walk around for a couple of hours after your brunch or lunch. Central Park changes colors for the season. If you come during summer, it'll be all green and flowers also.
Yeah,
some mostly green. During the fall, it'll be that really nice orangey golden color. And right now, since it's the peak winter, it's all brown. Right now we are on the Bow Bridge, and this is one of the most popular photo spots in Central Park. And there are also a lot of shoots which happen. So right next, there's a maternity shoot happening. And if you want to get a really nice picture here with view of Manhattan in the background, then this is a place that you need to be. Another way to explore Central Park is by taking a horse carriage ride, and they take you around the entire park, but it's a little expensive. It'll cost you about $50. A much cheaper option is to rent a cycle or a rickshaw like this, where you can pay per minute. And this is also a little on the pricier side. It costs you about $5 per minute. But if you cannot walk or if you're too tired and you still want to see the park, then this is a good option. We are now at another popular spot in Central Park. What is this called?
This is the Bethesda Mountain. Bethesda Fountain.
Bethesda Fountain.
I don't know how to pronounce it correctly,
okay.
But I can spell it.
It's a fountain.
It's a fountain.
Okay, and what's so popular about this?
I think I have seen it in a lot of movies, so that's why it's like, it's just nice to look at. And it's got a very pop culture symbolism for me. I'm sure it has other symbolism which we are not aware of.
Come here in the fall, you'll see water in the fountain. It's a working fountain.
Right now the fountain is empty. There's no water because it's winter.
In that background, you'll have all the fall colors, so it just looks amazing.
So this fountain and that arch, these are very, very popular spots you can spot this in Kal Ho Na Ho and also in a lot of English movies and TV series. Now we are out of Central Park and we are on the east side, and behind me the buildings and the road that you see are, I think, one of the most expensive apartments in New York. This is called the Upper East Side, and all these flats that you see are like super expensive and super high.
I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York.
The next stop for the day is the Met. Met is the Metropolitan Museum of Art, and this is one of the most popular museums in New York. And this is something that you can combine with the day you are seeing Central Park, because it's very, very close to that. So you get out from the east side of the Central Park and you can come and see the Met. And the entry fee for this is about $25. So again, if you're really into museums and or if it's a cold, windy day like this and you want to spend some time indoors, then it's a good option to come and check out the Met. The Met Gala event also happens here every year, and these steps that you see behind me are very, very popular again. You would have seen them in a lot of movies, in a lot of TV series, and it's again a very popular picture spot here in New York. This area also has a lot of cafes and restaurants, so if you want to get a coffee or grab something to eat, you can do that. And abhi kafi thand ho chuki hai, it's almost 4 o'clock, so next we're gonna go grab a coffee and then continue with the rest of the day. How's your macchiato?
French style.
The hot chocolate is really good. Wanna try? You try?
It's quite sweet for my
taste. It's sweet, but I expected that from a hot chocolate.
Then normally, Max Brenner again, the coffee.
Oh yeah, nice. Compare this with the Max Brenner one.
That is better.
That's better for sure. Okay. So a very popular place in New York for hot chocolate is Max Brenner. And I think that comes with toppings, with marshmallows and a lot of things. So if you're looking for a really good cup of hot chocolate, have that. But I like this one as well. Avenue is also a very nice place to just do some window shopping and check out the displays of a lot of big brands like Gucci, Dolce & Gabbana, Valentino. So even if you're not buying anything here, it's just nice to see the window displays of all these brands. And a lot of times they have a theme, especially during the December-Jan season when it's the holiday season. So make sure that you take a walk along the Madison Avenue, grab yourself something warm to drink like a hot chocolate, and admire the windows of all these brands. So guys, this was the video about Uptown Manhattan. So I hope this gives you an idea about how to plan your day here and also all the costs and other details involved. So before ending this video, here is my honest review and recommendation about Uptown. Is it worth coming here? Definitely yes. This is one area of Manhattan you do not want to miss because it's absolutely beautiful. I have been to all areas of Manhattan, Midtown, Downtown, the Financial District, but let me tell you, nothing compares to the beauty of Uptown. It's absolutely gorgeous, especially the Central Park. It has to be a must do if you're coming to New York. I have more videos on Manhattan, so if you're interested, do check them out. They're going to help you plan your trip. And before I end, I just want to tell you that if you're planning to come to New York for the first time, it can get a little overwhelming because itna kuch hai karne ke liye yahan pe, and there's so many things to figure out. I planned my trip for weeks before I came here. So if you want to skip doing all the research and, you know, make this process extremely easy, hassle-free and smooth for yourself, then you can book a one-to-one consultation session with me. Me and my team will help create a customized itinerary for you. It'll suit your budget, your time, your family, and also this way you'll not only just see New York, but you'll truly experience it. And if you're planning to come to New York, the first thing that you need to do is to get a US visa. So I have an entire playlist on the US visa process, right from filling the form to clearing the interview. So you need to check out this video series. The link is in the description box below. So I'm going to sign off here from the sunny place here in Central Park. See you in the next one. Bye.